matters is what's on the inside. What comes in must come out. Oh! Hello! God understands inside out more than anyone. Today, God wants his compassion to overflow into our hearts. God's compassion is feeling sympathy for someone who is suffering. God cares, so can we. God wants us to know his compassion for ourselves, and as a result, his compassion will then overflow to the people we know. Today, compassion also has something to do with shoes. The best way for overflow to happen is to ask the Holy Spirit to show us God's compassion. So, can we make the overflow prayer bigger than last week? Goggles on!
Dear God, please come and show us your compassion today, deep in our hearts. Overflow to us and then to our family, our friends, and everyone we meet.
Oh, man!
Hello, guys. Welcome to Carry Kids. My name is Ruth Haruna, and today we're going to be talking about compassion, God's compassion. As the professor explained today, we are going to be looking at how God cares, and so can we. God wants us to know his compassion for ourselves, and as a result, his compassion will overflow to the people we know. We are now going to start by looking at a Bible story which shows compassion in action. You know what? The scripture is going to be popping up on the screen right about now. We're reading from John chapter 11, and I will jump some verses. Just follow through with your own Bible if you have one with you. Verse 1 says, "There was a man named Lazarus who was sick. He lived in a town of Bethany, where Mary and her sister Martha lived." Verse 3. "So Mary and Martha sent someone to tell Jesus, 'Lord, the one you love is sick.' When Jesus heard this, he said, 'This sickness will not end in death. It is for the glory of God. This has happened to bring glory to the Son of God.'" Jesus loved Martha and her sister, and Lazarus as well. But when he heard that Lazarus was sick, he stayed where he was for 2 more days. Then Jesus said to his followers, "Let us go back to Judah." Verse 17. Jesus arrived in Bethany. There he learned that Lazarus had already been dead and in the tomb for 4 days. Verse 30. Jesus had not yet come into the town. He was still at the place where Martha had met him. The Jews were with Mary in the house, comforting her. They saw Mary stand and leave quickly. They followed her, thinking that she was going to the tomb to cry. But Mary went to the place where Jesus was. When she saw him, she fell at his feet and said, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." Jesus saw that Mary was crying, and that moved Jesus, who came with her. The Jews who came with her were crying too. Jesus felt very sad in his heart and was deeply troubled. He asked, "Where did you bury him?" "Come and see, Lord," they said. Then Jesus cried. So the Jews said, "See how much he loved him." But some of them said, "If Jesus healed the eyes of the blind man, why didn't he keep Lazarus from dying?" Again, Jesus felt very sad in his heart. He came to the tomb. The tomb was a cave with a large stone covering the entrance. Jesus said, "Move the stone away." Martha said, "But Lord, it has been 4 days since he died. There will be a bad smell." Martha was the sister of the dead man. Then Jesus said to her, "Didn't I tell you that if you believed, you would see the glory of God?" So they moved the stone away from the entrance. Then Jesus looked up and said, "Father, I thank you that you heard me. I know that you already hear me, but I said these things because of the people here around me. I want them to believe that you sent me. After Jesus said this, he cried out in a loud voice, Lazarus, come out. The dead man came out. His hands and feet were wrapped with pieces of cloth, and he had a cloth around his face. Jesus said to them, take the cloth off him and let him go. How does this Bible story make you feel? Now we're going to take some time to answer these questions, which will come up on your screen. Welcome back. In this story, Jesus reveals God's compassion. He feels sympathy for people who are suffering. God cares. So can we. Have you heard the expression, put yourself in their shoes? It means that you should look at what it's like to be a different person or to see something from their perspective rather than just yours. There are so many different types of shoes. We have sandals for summer, shoes for running, and a couple of other kinds of shoes. God is an expert at stepping into our shoes. He does not look from far away. Jesus became like us, so he understands what it is to be a baby, be hot or thirsty, run or hurt your knee. How does God's compassion overflow to us at the cross? At the cross, we can see God plants things differently to what we expect. Jesus' suffering and dying was the worst thing that could have happened to the one person who did not deserve it. At the cross, we see Jesus become weak, poor, hated, rejected. It looked and felt like everything had gone wrong. Jesus' friends at the time thought so too, but the cross was an extraordinary event where God identified with our experience. This is huge, and we truly know that God loves us because he shows his compassion to us through the death of his son. God wants to transform our hearts on the inside. He cares when we have worries and experience pain as Mary did. He wants to come close and hear what is happening, how we feel on the inside, and listen to our questions. You see the different kinds of shoes. God knows exactly how we feel. So how can you show others that God cares for them? This week, maybe at school, look out for someone who is sad and crying. Ask them what is going on. Listen to them. For hanging out with me today. I pray that you will enjoy God's compassion this week and extend it to others. God bless you.